Very good morning, students. I, Asad Patel, welcome you to study from home. Today I'm going to briefly explain you about the chapter number 1, the Earth in the Solar System, Geography for class 6. Now, how wonderful it is to watch sky after sunset. See, all of us likes to see sky after sunset. Why? Because there are so many stars, okay, twinkling in the sky, shining, okay. Sometimes once in a month there is full moon night, so we can enjoy that full moon, right? Soon you would see number of increasing. You cannot count them anymore, okay? Student, we can see only the star, but we cannot count them because the stars are countless, endless, right? Along with this bright object, you may also see the moon on the most of the day. It may, however, appear at a different time in a different shape, right? As I told you that we likes to see sky during night hours. Why? Because we can see so many stars, as well as, you know, we see moons and the different shape of the moon. That's why we like to see this star, this sky during the night hour. You can see the full moon only once about a month's time. It is a full moon night or Purnima. Okay, Purnima means full moon night. New moon night or Amavasya means in Amavasya moon is disappear. It's not disappear, but it is covered with the shed of the half part of the earth cannot see moon. So it is known as a Amavasya. One day this you can watch the night sky best provided it's clear night. Right. Do you wonder why can't we see moon and all this bright tiny object during daytime? Right? Why we can't see? Just because that moon, the light of a moon and light of a star is covered with the light of sun. Right? Sunlight is too shiny that cover. Okay? During day hour, half of the planet, half of the earth receives sunlight. That's why we cannot see the light of other objects like stars and moon. Okay. Now, it is because very bright light of the sun, as I told you, half of the part receives sunlight. The sun, the moon and all the objects shining in the night sky are called celestial bodies. Okay. Celestial bodies consist of star, satellite, not man-made satellite, okay? That organic natural satellite, moon, sun and other planets are known as a celestial bodies. Some celestial bodies are very big and hot, okay? They have their own heat as well as they have their own light. Sun is also star, but it is very big star in our solar system. Okay, I'm talking about solar system. Okay, they are made up of gases. They have their own heat and light which they emit in a large amount. These celestial bodies are called stars. The sun is also star. Okay, our solar system, for your information student, our solar system is in a galaxy. The name of our galaxy is Milky Way. Okay, name of our galaxy is Milky Way, and our solar system is a part of that Milky Way. Countless twinkling stars in the night are similar to the sun, but we don't feel their heat or light, and they look so tiny because they are very far from us. Right? Stars have own heat and light, but we cannot feel their heat and light as we feel heat and light of sun. Why? Just because stars are far away. not kilometers, but it is, you know, millions of kilometers far away from our Earth. You must have noticed that all objects look smaller when see from a distance. How small an aeroplane look when it is flying? While watching the night sky, you may notice various pattern formed by different means. When you look at the sky during night hour, you can make out some shape. This shape are known as a constellation. For example, you can see in this picture, right? You can see the shape. Ursa, a major big bear, is one such constellation. One of the most easily recognizable constellation is a Saptarshi, means a group of a seven stars, right? So let me tell you, let me repeat myself once again, that celestial bodies are sun, moon, planets, satellite and stars. Constellation means shape of star. In ancient time, people used to determine direction during the night with the help of star, right? See, in ancient time, they don't have compass to direct place, to locate place, or to get any to get directions. Okay, so they use the stars. Okay, they took help of the stars and direct. Okay, the North Star indicate the north direction. It is called pole star. Okay, it always remain in the same position in the sky. We can locate the position of the pole star with the help of a Saptarshi, right? Some celestial bodies do not have their own heat and light. For example, planets don't have their own heat and light. They are lit their light by the light of the stars, such as a bodies are called planets. The word planet come from the Greek word planetia, which means wanderer. Earth on which we live is a planet, right? All these planets are wanderer. It's rotate as well as revolve around the sun. Rotation means movement of the planets on its axis. Revolution means movement of the planet around the sun on a fixed path or a orbital path, right? It get all its heat and light from the sun, which is our nearest star. If we look at the Earth from the great distance, say the moon, it will appear to be a shining just as the moon. The moon that we see in the sky is a satellite. It is a companion of our Earth. Okay, the satellite, moon is satellite because moon also revolve around the Earth. Okay, and we have two types of satellite. One is man-made satellite and another is natural satellite. Moon is a natural satellite. Solar system. What is solar system? Solar system consists of a sun. Sun is our head of solar system. Okay, head of our solar family. Planets. Okay, satellite, asteroid, meteorites. Okay. Solar system, so together this all the celestial body form a solar system, like sun, planet, star, satellite, asteroid and meteoroid. You can observe the solar system in this picture. Okay, now let me explain you all the celestial body separately. The sun is the center of the solar system as well as head of our solar family. It is a star
which has its own heat and light, and it is the biggest member in our solar system or in our solar family. Okay, see students, sun is too hot to observe. Okay, scientists cannot observe the surface of the sun because hot gases and heat comes out from its surface. Now planets, there are 8 planets. Before few years back there were 9 planets, but Pluto has been removed, so now we have 8 planets. These are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Among this 8 planet, Earth is a unique planet in our solar system or in our solar family. How? Life is possible only on Earth. Okay, Earth has a blanket of a layer which is called atmosphere. Atmosphere consists of some layer like ozone, which protect our Earth from the harmful rays coming out from the sun, that are ultraviolet rays. Second thing, Earth, the environment of Earth is very friendly to survival of living organism. Earth has a water, okay, domain of water, that is very necessary for the life. Now, all the 8 planets revolve around the sun. Okay, now the moon is a satellite, the natural satellite. Okay, moon is a companion of Earth. Our Earth has only one satellite, that is the moon. Its diameter is only 1/4 that of the Earth. It appears so big because it is near to our planet than other celestial bodies. It is 384,400 kilometers away from us, right? Now come to the asteroid. Apart from the stars, planet and satellite, there are numerous tiny bodies which also move around the sun. These bodies are called asteroid. They are found between the orbit of Mars and Jupiter. Scientists are of the view that asteroids are part of planet which exploded many years back. That second thing, meteoroids, the smallest pieces of a rock which move around the sun are called meteoroids. Sometimes these meteoroids come near the Earth and tend to drop upon it. During this process, due to the friction which the air, they get heated and burned. It causes a flash of a light. Sometimes a meteor, without being completely burned, fall on the Earth and creates a hollow. Student, this is all about chapter 1. Now I am going to begin chapter number 2, and that is globe, latitude and longitude. Now what is globe, what is latitude and what is longitude? Globe is a model of Earth which can give the idea that how Earth is look like, as well as it helps us to locate places on that globe, right? You can see figure 2.1, that is the example of globe. Now latitude, what is latitude? Latitude is a horizontal line on the Earth, and let me tell you one thing, these horizontal line are imaginary line. We human or a cartographer is a person who prepare a map. So the cartographer draw this line to locate places on the globe. Longitude, straight line, okay, or a vertical line is known as a longitude. This latitude and longitude lines are an imaginary line to locate places, right? That helps us to locate places on the globe. You can see in figure 2.1 this 2 point. Your globe is slightly tilted. This our earth is also slightly tilted and rotate on its axis, right? You can see this 2 axes, okay? Another imaginary line run on the globe divides it into 2 equal parts. That line is equator, okay? Equator divide our earth into 2 part, and these are the northern part and southern part. Southern part is the down part, northern part is a up part, okay? The northern half of the earth is known as a northern hemisphere, and southern half of the earth is known or is called as a southern hemisphere. All parallel circles from the equator up to the poles are parallels of a latitude. Latitude are measured in a degree, okay? And latitude are a parallel line. What is parallel line? Those the lines which cannot meet at a single point. For example, lines of a railway, okay? Railway line, okay? This railway line cannot meet at a single point. That's why this line are called as a parallel line. The equator represents the 0 degree latitude. Since the distance from the equator to either of the poles is 1/4 of a circle around the earth, it will measure a 360 degree 90 degree north latitude marks the north, okay, and pole 90 degree south latitude marks the south pole, okay? Important parallels of latitude. Beside the equator, the north pole 90 degree and the south pole 90 degree, there are 4 important parallels of latitude: Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Arctic Circle, Antarctic Circle. Okay, you can observe this Arctic Circle, Antarctic Circle, Tropic of Cancer, and Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, this imaginary line divided earth into some zone, that is freeze zone, okay, temperate zone, torrid zone, okay. This divided earth into 3 zones, okay. Heat zone of the earth, that is torrid zone. Midday, sun is exactly overhead at last once a year on the latitude in between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. This area therefore receive maximum heat, that is called torrid zone, temperate zone. Neither too hot nor too cool, right? So that is temperate, means climate is not that much of hot and not that much of cool. Okay, so that is temperate zone. Now freeze zone. This zone receive minimum sun rays. That's why the temperature is during winter -45 and during summer 10 or 15. That's why it is known as a freeze zone. And another thing, the surface is a cover with snow in or throughout the year. That's why it is called freeze zone. What are longitude? To fix the position of a place, it is necessary to know something more than the latitude of that place. You can say, for example, that Tonga Island and Mauritius Island, okay, are situated on the same latitude. Now, in order to locate them precisely, we must find out how far east or west this from given line. Okay, so this is how you can locate place on globe. Now, prime meridian, you can see prime meridian in figure 2.16. the value of prime meridian is 0. Okay, so why prime meridian is important? Just because we can measure time through the prime meridian. For example, the value of prime meridian is zero. So let's, you know, start from prime meridian. If you go toward the western countries, time will be decrease, okay? And if you go to eastern countries, time will be increased. Means western countries are behind and eastern countries are away. For example, time distance between India and America means United States of America, USA, is 12 hours behind from India, right? Now you can observe figure 2.7. These are some line of longitude line and latitude line. This longitude and latitudinal line are helped to locate places. For example, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? If you want to locate place, A1, okay, B4, this is how we can locate places on this globe. Student, this is time zone, right? Longitude and time. The best means of measuring time is by the movement of the earth, okay, the moon and the planets. The sun regularly rises and sets every day, and naturally it is the best timekeeper throughout the world. Local time can be reckoned by a shadow cast by the sun. I told you we can measure time through the prime meridian, okay, and the value of prime meridian is zero, right? Now why do we have a standard time? The local time of a place which are different meridian are bound to different. For example, it will be difficult to prepare timetable for the train which crosses several longitude in India. Okay, India also have a several longitude line. That's why it is difficult to schedule the time. Okay, now let me give you an example that Assam sun rises and sun set in Assam 2 hours early than the Gujarat. So it would be a difficult for us to adjust the time. That's why we have a local time, okay, Indian standard time. So let me revise myself once again that globe is useful to locate the places, and longitude and latitude also give exact location, and prime meridian is useful to measure the time. Okay, so this is all about this two chapter, student. Thank you.